at one point in my career, I was working in a correctional institution. I was the assistant warden, and what we were doing in this institution was trying to help transition inmates from living within an institution to living in society. We weren't typical in the sense that we also had counseling services and employment services. We worked with a lot of employers in the area. We weren't finding them jail jobs, as they would be called. These are their careers. These jobs were meant that the day you get released, you're going back to work that day. You know, you're not going anywhere else. This is your job. This is what you're doing for however long you're gonna do it. And I remember the amazement. We had worked with this car dealership in the area, and we sent an inmate over. He wanted to be a car salesman. Like, all right, the guy was willing to take him. The guy was amazed. He worked there actually for a couple years. He ended up being with us. His length of sentence left was a couple years, and so he stayed at that job. Very shortly after working that job, he stayed as the number one salesperson of the month, every single month that he was there. And here is a guy that you would say is a hardened criminal. He's in for drug distributions, all of your charges that you would give somebody who is gang affiliated, and kind of a kingpin with it. He was pretty up there in the Baltimore drug world as far as the selling and the dealing and, you know, working his stuff. So you're talking about somebody who's worked the streets, who now is going to work every single day in a very nice button-down suit, and the number one car salesman every single month for 2 years. And when the amazement of that manager, you know, is, I just don't get it. I mean, not just because he's an inmate, but nobody gets top salesman every single month for length of time. I mean, I just don't get it. So I finally sat that inmate down one day. I was like, look, this is awesome. So I'm not saying this in any negative way, but how are you doing this? How is this happening? And I'm not meaning any negatives. I really am curious. And he had looked at me and he said, I worked the streets. I was one of the top in Baltimore of selling and moving product. I was good at it. I made money. I didn't get caught till later. He said, I take the exact same stuff I did then. Product is different. I moved illegal product and did it well. I'm moving legal product and I'm doing it well. For him, there was no difference in technique. The difference is the product. The difference was he wasn't looking over his shoulder, as he would say every time somebody drove a car off the lot, you know, but he took the exact same stuff that he knew in the illegal days and made it legal. And one of the reasons he did that, because he could have went back into the drug world when he had left. And one of the reasons he did that is his idea was, you know, I did get caught. I'm not gonna get in trouble doing this. And I can make the same amount of money or more doing this than I was doing that. He said, I'm gonna tell you, this is just a practical business sense. That's the only reason I'm doing this, and I'm doing well at it. I'm gonna stay doing well at it, even when I leave jail, because it's legal. And I'm making good money. If I wasn't making good money, I might go back to that. So I think what I learned, you know, in the moral of this, you know, where do you kind of go with this, and what would I do with my clients is, you know, regardless of our past is our past. What do we learn from our past? And maybe everything in our past is not as negative as we think it is. There may be some skill sets that if tweaked, we can still use. We don't need to totally reinvent the wheel from who we were to who we are. We may want to change who we are, but we don't have to change and reinvent some of our core features of who we are.